Hi guys, today in this episode we will continue the work around the MC-909 synth engine, and in this part we will touch the tone or voice generator itself. Let me open the MC-909 editor, and to reach these functions you have to open the edit window, and from here you have to choose the wave or pitch editor window. Maybe it's already too much, but believe me, this is really simple. This one here is your part, which is a part of your sequence. Inside in every part you have the voice, okay? And in a voice you have the four tone. So tone 1, 2, 3 and 4. And each tone generator can contain two individual waveform. But in most of the case you just have to deal with only one waveform. The next section it's about the waveforms. Don't be confused with the patch selector here, because this is a total different animal. This one will load a complete voice into the part. Meanwhile, this one, it's about which kind of waveform you wanna use in a specific tone generator. From here, you have three options. One is the internal. The next one, if you have SRX board installed into your MC-909, then of course you can see here the list of the waveforms from the SRX board, or you can choose a direct sample libraries. From this you have again three options. One is your user sample library, the other is the card, you know, this card. This one is always filled up with some kind of Roland specific sample library from your firmware update. I'm using the 2.13, if I remember good, and this one is filled up with a lot of R&B vocals, breaks, human voices and what's not. The user sample source, it's not as simple to understand, so I think I will do other episode around this, because for the user samples you have to do a lot of work on your computer, you have to load into your MC-909, and then you have to prepare the samples in the MC-909, but these steps you can do only from the control surface of the MC-909. Of course, you will see this process in the next episode. So let's jump back to the tone generators. For this example, we will use the internal waveforms, and from that I choose already the simple sinusoid wave, but you have here tons of options, almost 700 different samples what you can load in. What's the big deal about the internal sample library? When you start to design your own voice, I highly recommend you to have a look around the built-in internal patches first, and then if you find something really close or similar what you want to do, but nothing can stop you to combine different waveforms from different built-in patches in your own voice patch, to play around the samples and mix them and smash them together until you get the best results. But in this example, of course, I want to keep everything as simple as possible. Make sure you guys can hear everything. The next part is the waveforms itself. But here we have a really nice option to load different waveforms for the left and to the right channel. This is a kind of weird animal here in Roland XV synth engines, because this will give you option to create a monotone or a true stereo tone. So what is mean? You can create a really sophisticated stereo mix in one part. So if you have a really nice sample from piano, which is recorded on stereo way, so you have already this really nice and really wide stereo piano sound, you can chop up to the left channel and to the right channel, and then this is the two samples what you can load into the tone generator of the MC-909, or in most of the case, because this is a groove box and a drum machine, we use this function to take out really nice drum loops and drum samples from other CDs or from hip-hop records or whatever, and then we chopped up to left and to the right, and this is what we loaded into the tone generator. But nothing can stop you to use this function to double the amount of pseudo polyphony of your MC-909 synth engine. So you easily can load up two total different waveforms, okay, to the left and to the right channel, and later on,
I will show you,
you can mix them together on some kind of weird way, so it will be not like a same like you have eight tone generator under one voice, but it will do something. Let me show you the normal mono first. So this is a normal sine wave. Okay, so this is absolutely mono at the moment. But what will happen if we load here a total different waveform? Let's say, for example, this trend show. Okay, then now the sine wave will came only on a left channel, and the trans saw wave will came only on a right channel. So when you play on your keyboard, okay, but how we can make this one like a kind of a mixed mono? It's unfortunately not here in this editor window. For that you have to open the amp envelope editor window. I don't know why Roland did like this, but here is a really, really nice trick. So now, if you turn this pan pot, okay, to the maximum left, what will happen? It's a... you just have to listen. Now, the right channel, which is the trans saw wave, it came somehow to the center, and the sine wave, which is on the left, it came somehow to the bit of the right. And the phases, it's already like some kind of really weird mixture. Okay, let me do some more weird, for example, overheim saw. So now, the mixture of the two saw wave, it came to the center, yeah? But they still have this wide stereo field. So now you can imagine what you can do with this if you switch on all of your tone generator with the same waveforms, but you just
inverted them. So here left channel OB, okay? And here right channel OB, and then here again load up the
trans, and here load up the trans, and here load up the OB.
Now we play a bit with this pan pot. So this one absolutely to the left, this one absolutely to the left, because now this is inverted. And now this we will keep, let's say, here. And now this we adjust, let's say, to here. Okay, so now, if I play on a keyboard, this will be a really, really, really massive. Yeah? okay, I think you get the idea, huh? The next section, it's about the tone delay. It's a really sophisticated and really nice tool in all XV synth engine, and I think I will do a separate video about this, because with the tone delay function you can do unbelievable things in your groove box. Let me show you some really cool feature with this trick. So for that you have to load one waveform to one tone generator and the other waveform to the other tone generator. As you can see here, the first tone generator will reply immediately for the key presses. Let me show you. So this is a really simple super saw. Okay, but the other one is from the old analog classic, and this is some kind of square wave. The difference between the two tone generator, this one is on plus one octave and this is on zero octave. So if you don't apply here tone delay, yeah, then this two tone generator will play together as a one octave chord, something like this. So, yeah, nothing really fancy, but here you can add a tone delay, but not only by millisecond, but also based on your tempo, yeah? So, for the best demonstration, this is a half. This is already weird, huh? But don't forget, we didn't touch the delay function of the mixer itself, and we didn't touch the arpeggiators or chord memory or RPS sets, nothing. We still only in the tone generator, and we already get some kind of rhythmic function in our synth engine. So let me play, and I will play two different style with the same voice generation. Yeah? First I will play the first style, and then I will play the second style.
Idea.
Of course, you can use this with four tone in one voice. So your first tone can be a kick drum, your second tone can be a snare drum or a hi-hat or an open hat or whatever. So with one key press, you can play four different waveform under your one voice, which is based on your tempo. And the second trick, what I did with this, I always loaded a really simple stereo guitar voice to the first two tone generator. Then the last two, I loaded a really small, tiny kick drum and other kind of guitar body samplers. And then, of course, I applied a bit of delay between them. So then I get back this really rhythmic guitar body smashing playing style. My third favorite trick with that is to add additional delayed rhythmic bass line to the existing bass line in the sequence, which is not there. With this trick, you can insert a secondary bass, okay, which is based on your melody, but with a bit of delay. So it can be one bar or half bar or quarter or whatever. It depends on the music, of course. So in that way, you can create a really interesting, really floating, really rhythmic music with only two instruments. So one is your bass, one is your lead synthesizer, and this function can fill up the gap between the two, okay? And everything will be harmonic. And this is a really, really important part. Of course, you cannot apply this trick on any kind of music genre, but on a techno, on a house music, or on a hip hop, or whatever, you really can utilize this one. And then you can save a lot of voice capability from your MC-909. And don't forget, nothing can stop you to load human voices, animal voices, industrial noises. Believe me, this is a really, really, really nice feature. This one here is give you even more option to play with this tone delay function. And this is why I said I will do a separate video about this. The next one is some kind of really simple story here. This is the original gain of the tone. So this is not the same like what you have here, okay? Or what you have here. This is the gain of the specific tone. And of course you can apply different level of gain on each tone. But there is a limitation here. You can adjust only by 6 dB steps. So you have four options here. And maybe it's familiar, but you have four tone generator and you have four different gain level. Don't forget, the good bass sounds also contain high frequencies, not only low frequencies. And with these gain pots here, you can super tune or hyper tune your bass synthesizer. I think you can understand what this gain is doing. The next one is the FXM engine of the XV synthesizer. This is a really weird animal because with this you can create a really unique sound what you cannot create with any kind of other instruments in a whole universe. Of course, you can utilize analog sound from guitar, from piano, from whatever, and then you can apply on it this FXM modulation, and then you will get something really, really, something really crazy. Let me show you. Without FXM, nice, and with FXM on full depth. Okay, so now we add more color. And now we add more color. As you can see, this is a really simple sine wave. But the next part, it's more interesting. So it's still kind of sine wave. This one is the original sine wave, yeah? And the second part is some kind of delayed, smashed, I don't know what is this. And on top of it, the whole waveform is modulated with some kind of low frequency sinus amplitude modulation. This one, it's even more weird. So now the phase modulation is inverted. Okay, so now we have the original sine wave here up to something like this, but the phase is inverted here and this amplitude modulation, it's gone. So now it's flat. And if we go to the last, which is the highest settings, yeah, then we get even more weird. Now you can see. So here is the phase modulation. So the time is modulated. And also the amplitude is modulated by itself. And now you can imagine what you can do with normal analog sounds. Let me load a normal piano or something. Steel guitar, yeah. Use a steel guitar, yeah?
Nice. It's ugly.
If we push this to the maximum.
Yeah.
Aha, now we arrived, eh? So minus one octave.
It's kind of boring, no? So use some kind of GP800, yeah, feedback oscillation.
Next one, it's really simple. This is about the tuning of the tone, not the voice and not the system. Okay, so this one will tune your whole part, okay? And this one will tune only your tone generator under your part. So what you can do with this? For example, you can generate an organ sound from a simple sine wave, because this is how the organs are working, yeah? So I don't know how it's called this kind of organ tone, but you can hear it. So this is the sine wave alone, okay? And now if we switch on the other tone generators, which is running on different tuning, okay, then you will get, of course, organ sound. Or you can do a really nice synthesizer, yeah? So now we created an organ which is based on a GP8 waveform, yeah? You really easily can simulate the voice of the Waldorf XDK synthesizer, which is based on wavetables. Yeah? Let me show you the fine-tune option, because with this fine-tune option you can generate much more interesting sounds. So without the chorus engine, you can create a chorus with this option. So you know what, let me add a bit of panning here, so bit left, bit right, bit left and bit right, and now still one kind of waveform in one voice. No other additional reverb, FX, chorus, whatever. We just played a bit with the tuning option. The next one is the randomizing your pitch. Let maximum. What this doing actually? On every note press, yeah, really important, on every note press, this will modify the original tune and the pitch by some kind of random number, and this is the multiply factor here. So with 1200 you will get, if I remember good, 2 octaves, something like this, and with 100 you will get a few semitones or half tones. Maybe it sounds weird on a first, eh? But let me show you what you can do with this. So
9. 30, 20, and 20, good.
On every key press, you will get different kind of modulation. Let me show you in Adobe Audition software. Maybe you can see already, but each of the key presses, it has its own unique waveform, okay? And it has its own unique modulation. Maybe you can see here, but this one is totally different than what we have, for example, here. And this is came from these really slight, really small changes in the randomization of your tone generator. So, of course, you can go fully weird with that, so nothing can stop you to out here 1200 and here 500 and I don't know 700 whatever.
Oh my god.
Okay, the next one, it's even more interesting, and we still around the tuning option of the tones. This one here is how your pitch will follow your key presses. So not the velocity and not the aftertouch, nothing. Is about how the pitch will change with your notes. So, and normally, you know, you have, let's say, 1 octave, and you play on 1 octave, so C. So this is 1 octave, okay? And this one here, now 100. But, what you can do with that? You can double this. So C0 will become C0, but C1 will become C2. You can create with that even a synthesizer of the fulls, which is going on negative. So the notes actually going backwards. And if, of course, if you zero this out, it's meaning whatever you play on your keyboard, this tone generator will not follow the notes. When this can be helpful? Drums. But the Roland MC-909 is a groovebox or a drum machine, yeah? I don't know who can do any kind of hip-hop or R&B song on a Roland MC-909 without using this function, eh? In a voice generator. So, what you wanna do with this? First of all, not all kind of scratches are good for different hip-hop songs. This is one. Second, you easily can create this really plasticky, really harsh, really cheap synthesizer kind of scratched hip-hop song. So how you can create a really good scratches to your hip-hop music in a Roland MC-909 to utilize these key follow pitch changes? Enable or disable, or it's on a negative. Let me show you. First, you have to find the right scratch sound. So, this is this kind, okay? But all the rest, it's a single waveform. So what is mean? The same waveform will applied to each note, but of course with a different pitch. Yeah, this is sounds nice. So now the problem is we follow the pitch. So this what I don't want at all. So how I can switch off this? It's very simple. The pitch follow the key, it's on zero. So now, whatever I press on these notes, okay, this will be always the same. Okay. Yeah, it sounds good. So now, with the simple changes of the length of the notes and the pitch of the notes, we can play different style of scratching. Let me show you. So this is one note for a really short period. Okay, this is a long note on the same pitch. And this is two notes after each other with a really short period. And now I will keep the first one pressed, then I just will play with the second one on top of it. You can imagine what you can do with four different scratch noise with this technique. Okay, but we didn't apply yet something else. Let me show you. Okay, now is the time to load other scratchy. Okay, this is really nice. And now we will add a delay, which is much more longer. And of course, we will switch off the key follow back to zero. Yeah, something like this. So now what will happen? When I will press the C0, first this one will play, and then this one will play, and then this one will play. Okay, just listen. But, because all of the tone delay mode is still on normal, doesn't matter what I'm doing with the notes, these things will be played, okay? So, here is the time when we have to add the hold function to the last one. So, what this will do? If I'm not holding the note, let me show you. So, if I'm not holding the note here, then the third tone will not play at all. So, let me show you. I will not hold now. So, here we have only the push-pull and this noise from the needle. But if I'm holding it, then after these two will become the third one. So, let's play the music and we will play a bit with this scratch technique.
I know I'm not a guy from Detroit. Eh? You like it, eh?
So with this function here, combined with the tone delay, okay, and combined with the tune, you easily can create a really, really interesting scratches, noises, carpets, whatever into your song. Let's jump to the next section, which is about the envelope curve of the pitch. The T1, it will define the first section of the envelope, okay? You can see what's going on here. So the level zero, will adjust the first point, okay? Then the level one will adjust the second one. And you know what, let me spread everything like this. Then level two will adjust the third one, and so on, and so on, and so on. But here we have some really weird animal. This section here, it's about the sustain level. So this is your sustain level, and this one here, this curve, is your release curve. But the nicest things about this one, again, each of your tone generator can hold its own pitch envelope curve. Aha! Really nice. What will happen now if I press the key? Nothing. And the reason for that is this fader here, which is about the depth. So the depth, if it's on 12, okay, maybe this T1 and the T2, it's a bit too long, okay. If you're moving this fader here, you easily can create a negative curve without redrawing and readjusting all of the parameters in your envelope. So now, everything will go opposite. So first you will hear the tone will go down and then will come up. And may you already heard when this function can be really, really, really helpful. Of course, when you are playing with bass, you know? So let's load some really nice bass, GP8. But you completely can eliminate the first time. So then, you know what, let me load some techno pattern to show the full power of this pitch envelope. And I didn't decide yet, I will make from this bass or lead, I don't know. But I like the sound, so, and you know what, let's make a bit difference between them. I kind of like it. First one here, and the second one here, and it will be mirrored, eh? Okay, kind of crazy. What we have now? We have two different kind of tone in one voice. Both of the tone will follow the key presses, okay? But the two tone has its own pitch envelope. And we will see here in the adobe audition how the frequency spectrum is changing. Okay, so play and a lot of really, really interesting bizarre bazaar on a beginning. And this is really, really important for any kind of bass, okay, or low tonal lead synthesizer, to make sure you have something on a beginning, like a percussion lead in into the bass tone itself. Of course, this is depend on our style, but most of the case, we need something on a beginning, yeah? I hope you can understand, basically, the pitch envelope curves, it's a really fundamental part of any kind of synthesizer in a planet, but the Roland MC-909, because he give you four different pitch envelope per voice, you can do a really, really crazy things. And don't forget, you can apply different pitch height for your sustained voices. So with this, you easily can create a really harmonic, really interesting, really moving melodic part if you play with, for example, strings or this really weird techno trumpets. It's an excellent tool for that. And it's also good for hip hop music. You just have to drop in some kind of pipe or flute or whatever, and then with these really slight changes in a pitch envelope, you can create this really interesting high frequency, high pitch carpets on a low volume, just to fill up the gap between the hi-hats and the high frequencies, and between the kick drum and between the heavy bass and between the rap itself. So, but the best what you can do is to load the factory presets into your MC-909 and then check them one by one, most of the case, the big trick is hidden in the pitch envelope. So you must to play with that, you must to try it, and you must to learn from the factory presets. So let me jump back to the MC-909 and finish this techno song. Okay, in the same time, I want to demonstrate to you the release pitch envelope, okay, which is, you know, the first section in the envelope. I don't think so I have to explain to you guys what's mean these different part of the envelope, so the attack, the decay, the sustain, and the release. If you don't know, please go to the Wikipedia, for example. There is tons of really nice explanation about the synthesis and what these different parts of the envelopes is meaning. So in our case, now I have to add a bit of release, okay, to the amp envelope to make sure you guys can hear what's going on in a release time. So now we have a release time. So what is mean when I press the note here, the voice itself, it will fade out in the time what we adjusted here. Without release time. But because at the moment the T4, which is the release time, okay, of the pitch envelope, it's zero, then we will not hear nothing. Change, okay? To see the time 4, you have to add a level 4, doesn't matter if it's positive or negative, so just for demonstration. So here is the level 4. Do you remember for these other settings, okay, around the general and around the amplification, which is saying here, no sustain or sustain. If this set to no sustain, then of course will be no sustain at all. So let me demonstrate to you. Now I will press no sustain, and then the tone pitch will follow the envelope. Because we have here release time, yeah? Then what will happen if I press the note for a really short time of period? The synth engine will try to follow this envelope curve, and doesn't matter where I release the note, okay, the system will connect these two points together. Let me demonstrate to you. So this one is like a longer note. When I release the key, okay, then the pitch will go down. But what's happened if I press this note really shortly, really rapidly? But if I play a long note, you get a picture, eh? So you can increase the variation in your melody in one part. So let me go back again and engage the second tone in a voice, okay? So what we have now here, one is this trance oscillator and the other is this simple digital oscillator. So now I switched off the first one, and now I will engage only the second one. Okay, and here we don't have any kind of level on the release time or no sustain or nothing. Eh? Okay, so now it's zero. Okay, this is really nice. I really like it because if I will play together with the filter, yeah? And don't forget, this is only one voice, two tone, huh? Okay, engage together with this really nice techno pattern.
I'm kind of lazy guy, so let's switch on some arpeggiator.
Sorry for this really ugly performance, but you can get a picture what you can do only with the pitch envelope curves if you apply a different envelope curve to each of your tone, not each of your voice. Let me go back a bit to this fader, so potmeters here, time key follow. With this option, you can simulate how the really old samplers and old sequencers are worked with the samplers. Okay, how I can explain this to you? For example, you have a sampler, okay, and you created a sampler from one of your analog synthesizer, but the sample itself is containing some kind of pitch envelope curve. So what will happen? If you play back this waveform in your sampler, of course, how you rise the pitch, so you go up with the notes from C0 to C7, whatever, this waveform will be shortened, 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 and shortened. Then, of course, the pitch curve, which is burned in into the sample, it will also follow, okay, quasi the key presses. You can simulate this with this potmeter. So let me show you. If you push this to the 100%, then this curve will follow the notes. So the high pitch notes will have a really short time, okay? A low pitch notes, bass, whatever, they will have a long, really long time. Okay, and then high note. Here, okay, we have this long transition, but here you can see we just have this long. Of course, you can mix all these together, so a really big variation in a pitch envelopes, but you just add 50% of key follow, so then you will get a really nice variation on a slight changes of the pitch of your voice. If your waveform is already some kind of busy, some kind of modulated, I don't know what kind of waveform, avoid from this, because this can create a really, really ugly, really plasticky sound. So let me show you the next potmeter, which is again really important. This is the velocity sensitivity of your pitch envelope. Don't forget, the MC-909 has a velocity sensitive pads. Okay, so if you apply here velocity sensitivity, okay, to the pitch envelope, and just for the demonstration, I will rise this time up a bit, then you can play with the pitch envelope by simply press harder or softer the pads or your MIDI keyboard. So let me show you. So, slightly touches, okay, no pitch changes, but if I press harder, harder, and of course we can apply this to the second one with different settings, so negative. So what will happen now, if I press this note more hardly, okay, then our pitch envelope will become more flat. The next one, which is this one, which is the T1 sensitivity, it's again connected to the velocity of the note, okay? How it's working, if you press harder, okay, so you increase the velocity of your note, then this time period will become shorter, 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 shorter. Let me show you. So now I will just touch it really slightly. Then we will have this really long change. Harder. So what you can do with this, you just have to apply some kind of changes in the velocity curves in your DAW software or in a sequencer of the MC-909. Then you can variate a lot the pitch envelope curves. Let's go to the next one, which is the T4 sensitivity. So this period is after the release. Eh? Now I will increase the T4 sensitivity, which is connected again to the velocity. So now if I play really softly on this note. But if I press really hardly, then we will hear this mu on an end. Now I think is the best time to play a bit with this really crazy bass line what we just created, only with the pitch envelopes and only with the tone generator really basic settings.
And a bit of LFO, sorry for that, but I'm kind of lazy to turn the filter knob all the times.
Let me show you what we get now. So I will play this note and this note now. Yeah, this note and this note now.
This I like, and this one, so.
Okay, so. Play this really nice techno.
Idea now.
Only with two tone in a voice and with a really bit of changes in the pitch envelope, we created this really weird and really massively moving modulated bass line, which is still has a rhythm and all the goodies for the bass. So there is a bit of high frequencies on a beginning, there is a lot of additional frequencies what you really can utilize in a filter. And also on a resonance of the filter, and you can feed into the reverb engine because it's so rich on a high frequencies, but it's still a bass. And
I'm 100% sure nobody did this kind of crazy and ugly bass sound with the MC-909.
I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, and in the next episode we will jump into the filter envelopes and into the filter settings. Until that, see you next time. Bye.